by the Laplace transform of f of t plus the integral from 0 to t, t minus u, f of u du equals t. So for this one, as you can see, we have the integral involved, and we cannot find the Laplace transform directly from this one. So if you remember, the integral can be written as this one using the convolution. So we have t convoluted with f of t. So this is small f of t, okay? And this is the whole thing. Here becomes this. So when I take the inverse Laplace transform on both sides, I have capital F of S plus the Laplace transform of this is 1 over S squared times capital F of S equals 1 over S squared. And then factor out capital F of S. I left with 1 plus 1 over S squared equals 1 over S squared. Okay? Now, to get rid of the S squared, I'm going to multiply both sides by S squared. So on the left side, I have S squared times S squared plus 1 equals 1. Okay? So let me write it out here. Multiply both sides by S squared. Alright, so that's a little note here. Now divide both sides by S squared plus 1. Right, so this is the inverse function of capital of f of t. Now we need to find f of t. So we are going to take the inverse transform of it, which is just back to f small f of t, and the inverse transform of this one is just psi of t. Okay, so this should be your final solution eventually. That's it. So as you can see, we went from this world to another world, and then we solve it in another world, then we went back to this world. It's easier to do it this way instead of find what f t is used after using if you integrate the integral here. Okay, so this is the benefits of doing using the Laplace transform. Hope it makes sense. If you find the video is helpful, feel free to give it a like, share, and subscribe to my channel in order to receive the most current videos. Don't forget to hit the bell so that you won't miss anything. I'll see you next time.